guys, it's Marco in the Easy Shop, and welcome to part 3 of our mold making experiment. Today is the day that we mix the compounds together and pour them into the mold, and hopefully in a couple of days we'll see the fruit of our labor. It should be a nice rubber bumper, about the same as that one over there that you see, although that one was actually machined on the mill. I was looking at a spec sheet for this urethane, and it says that within about 24 to 48 hours it's good enough to handle, hard enough to handle, but it takes about a week to fully cure. The temperature that I recommend for curing is 75 degrees, and they also say that hotter temperature makes it cure a little bit faster, which is a good thing. I probably heat up my shop to about 80 degrees and let it run all day. Incidentally, that's the same temperature that I use when I work with epoxy, so nothing new right there. But without further ado, let's get over there and mix the parts up and pour it in the mold and see how bad this can really go. What else could go wrong? All right, guys, pardon the fact that my head is gonna be slightly out of frame, but we are ready to go here. I'll show you the material once again, and then we get busy and start mixing up. The temperature in the shop is about 65 to 70 degrees, which is exactly what they suggest. So the mold, you've seen it in the previous video. I cleaned it up with acetone, and obviously these are the two parts, the mold itself, and I call these the funnels. I don't know what else to call it, but that's what creates the impression of the screw holes and the counterbore. And everything's cleaned up with acetone, ready to go. And let's see what else we got here. We got a scale. This is part A. Let me look at the instructions. The instructions said to pour part B first. So figure. So here's part B. And I got this stuff from uscomposite.com. Take a good shot at that one. And again, one part of these, two parts of those by weight, the tint, and a release agent. They prescribe this in the instructions for this stuff. Is Polyes 2300, buy from the same place as you buy the rest of these materials. And we're supposed to lightly spray the mold, and then we're good to go. So let's get busy. So first of all, we're gonna spray this release agent all over the mold. And I'm not really sure how much it needs, but I suppose as long as it's thoroughly covered. It becomes a little opaque, so it seems like I got it mostly everywhere. And let's mix this too, except I'm not gonna follow the instruction. Instead of mixing this first, I'm gonna mix that first, because I don't want to go any more than 2/3 the height of that cup, because I don't want to end up over spilling that. Now I warmed up the shop a little bit, so now the temperature of these chemicals has come up. This one's 74, that one's 73, and the shop itself is a 70, so it actually does flow a little bit better. So first of all, let's zero out this scale, and let's see. So that's 51, let's call it 50. Zero this up, and pour, oops, zero this out and pour 25 of this. Don't waste any of that stuff. And let's clean up the mess. And we're gonna start mixing it up. That's what ended up being 27. Hope it's okay. Well, this stuff is thick. I don't know if you can see, but look at it. Look at this. So I think it could probably stand to be warmed up a little bit more, but we'll go with what we got. Now the instruction says to mix it thoroughly, and obviously it says scrape the sidewalls of the cup. Well, this cup is just barely big enough. And you don't want to whip any bubbles into it, because then bubbles will end up in your part too, which is probably not a good thing. So hang in there while I mix this thing a little bit. And while I'm doing the mixing, I'm gonna put a little bit of this tint. This one also is kind of liquid. I don't know how much we need, but I'll just put some in there and see what happens. Let's see that much. Keep on mixing and see what we get. This is really dark, so I think we might be okay with even less than that amount. So it doesn't really take much tint at all. This thing is jet black with just that little bit of tint. We gotta keep mixing. Side, the corners down at the bottom. I kind of wish I had a bigger cup right now, to tell you the truth. Now normally when I do epoxy, I usually mix it for at least 2 minutes, and I usually look at the clock, but I haven't looked at this, at the clock. So let's go for it and pour it in, and hopefully we have enough. It looks like it's starting to get a little rubbery already. There you go. And all I really want is enough. Oh, should I have like almost enough for another one? All right, let me get you closer here. There you go. All I really wanted was enough to cover the part. You can see I still have quite a bit left. I don't know, maybe a third of a cup. Let me see, get you in the frame. Maybe like a third of a cup. I'll probably just leave it in here and see, you know, just as a comparison. It's very shiny. Looks really nice. It is a little bit, I don't know if you can see, but it's overflowing just a little bit. That's not a problem, because I can always kind of sand the part once it comes up, sand it a little bit flatter. But I could have probably used a little bit less. So that's where we are. We're just gonna leave it in there. Actually, I might just put this in the epoxy cabinet. That's probably a better idea, where it stays nice and warm. And who knows, maybe tomorrow we might be able to pull it out and take a look at it. So that's it for now. And I think so far it looks even better than the original, at least color-wise. So it's a little bit early to call it a success, but so far so good. We're just gonna wait until it gets a little bit harder, and it says up to a week, as we said, to before it's fully cured, and we'll see how difficult it is to pull the part out and take it apart and see if we actually got what we were looking for. So just hang in there, and we'll get the answer to our question in just a few moments. All right, guys, it's next morning, 12 hours later. Let's go see what we have. It's looking pretty good. Let's go see if we can take it out. All right, here we go. It's not coming. Uh-oh. Oh, sleep right now. That's pretty nice.
Yeah. Check this out.
Alright, so here it is with the stacks or funnels still on. And let's take it apart.
Have a better look at it.
So this should come right up. There he goes. Number one. And number two. Let's take a look at it. Wow, that's pretty nice. Yeah, I see maybe a few surface bubbles right there. At least I hope they're only in the surface. Let's make sure we're focusing in. You can barely see a little bit of the tool marks from the mold itself. The logo came out, yeah, pretty good. It could have made it a little deeper, perhaps. Those little air bubbles right there are pockets. Let's take a look at the counterbore. Counterbore looks sharp. That's excellent. Very nice. So hey, I think that's the win. And let me put next to the original. Let's see. This weighs a little more, but perhaps it's because of the hardware. Let's see if I can take the hardware out. Very similar. Hardness-wise, now this might be just a skosh softer, but hardly, very, very, very similar. I think it's a great durometer for this type of application. Excellent. And you can see just a few more, see if I can get a little closer, a few more surface bubbles right there. And perhaps right there. And you can see just a tiny little bit of surface imperfection due to like little bubbles. Obviously this little flange would have to come off, and this is actually standing up a little bit proud of that lip that we created. So you'd have to be sanded down, cut, you know, trimmed, and maybe a little sanded down right there. But overall, especially for being the first one, this is coming out great. You remember that cup that we had a lot of it leftovers in there? Well, I ended up ripping it apart and cutting it in half just to see if there are any bubbles on the inside. And the inside looks great. The little shiny spots are a sliver of aluminum from my bandsaw. I cut a lot of aluminum with it. This one, that's actually a dent that it wasn't there before. I think I must have banged it up while trying to take them apart or something. Not sure. So let's test it. I don't know. It doesn't really mark very well, so maybe that could have been something. Doesn't really seem significant. Overall, I'd say I'm 100% happy of the inside of this thing. And maybe 95% happy about how this turned out. All right, let's cut this thing with some shears and see.
knocked out the high spots. That looks pretty good. There it is, back to back. I guess the question is, will it fit on the airplane? Well, let's go find out right now. So there it is, the new long easy bumper from the mold. Yeah, that sure is shiny. It's looking great, actually. I'm very pleased. And once again, the point of the project was to be able to make a mold of something and come up with an object that we can use. So this time was the bumper, but now that we have this technology somewhat under control, we can do anything. Hey guys, so I hope you enjoyed this series, and stay tuned until the next project. See ya. You messed up the shot.
Now, let me see. Wow!
Come and check it out.
Check it out.
Pull it up.
Hey there.